In our news flash, after a big quake happened at Haiti, at least 304 people died and hundreds were injured or missing after a major earthquake struck southwestern Haiti on Saturday, authorities said, reducing churches, hotels and homes to rubble in the latest tragedy to hit the impoverished Caribbean nation. The 7.2 magnitude quake, which was followed by a series of aftershocks, struck 8 kilometers, 5 miles, from the town of Petit-Trou-de-Nips, about 150 kilometers west of the capital Port-au-Prince, at a depth of 10 kilometers, the United States Geological Survey said. That made the tremor, which was felt as far away as Cuba and Jamaica, potentially bigger and shallower than the magnitude 7 earthquake 11 years ago that killed tens of thousands on the island. This one, which occurred around 8:30 a.m. local time, hit farther away from the capital, however. In Port-au-Prince, it was strongly felt but did not appear to have caused major damage, according to the witnesses. Still, Haiti's Civil Protection Service said the preliminary death toll stood at 304, with at least 1,800 injured and more people unaccounted for. Preliminary rescue operations by emergency teams and ordinary citizens had enabled many people to already be recovered from the debris. At least 949 homes, 7 churches, 2 hotels and 3 schools had been destroyed, it said. A further 723 homes, 1 prison, 3 health centers and 7 schools had been damaged, although there was no major damage to port, airport or telecoms infrastructure. Prime Minister Ariel Henry, who flew over the region to survey the damage, declared a month-long state of emergency. The nearest big town was Lacaze, where many buildings collapsed or suffered major damage, according to authorities. I saw bodies being pulled out of the rubble, injured and perhaps dead people, said Lacaze resident Jean-Marie Simon, 38, who was at the market when the earthquake struck and ran home to see if his family was safe. I heard cries of pain everywhere I passed through. His wife and 2-year-old child had been bathing and rushed out to the street, naked, just before the front of the house crumbled. Simon gave his wife his shirt and they took refuge in the courtyard of a church with other locals. His mother's house had also collapsed. There are a lot of aftershocks and every time there's one, people run and shout, he said. My legs are still trembling. In Lacaze, locals said water had briefly flooded the coastal town of 126,000, causing panic amid fear of a tsunami, but then appeared to retreat. Haitian media outlets reported some people along the coast had already fled to the mountains. Videos posted to social media showed citizens pulling others from debris and crowds of people waiting for medical attention at overwhelmed hospitals. USGS said a significant amount of the population was at risk of landslides, with road obstructions likely. Haiti's Civil Protection Service said a landslide had blocked the highway between Lacaze and the town of Jeremy. Also, access by road to the southern region, where the quake struck, has been restricted by gang control of key areas, although Henry said police would accompany any convoys going to the south. The earthquake comes just over a month after the assassination of President Jovenel Moïse, who had been ruling by decree, which deepened the country's political turmoil. Meanwhile, swaths of Haiti are facing growing hunger and healthcare services are overwhelmed by COVID-19. That region had only recently recovered from Hurricane Matthew, which struck in 2016, killing hundreds and causing widespread devastation. This country just never finds a break. Each year of mismanagement did not hurt, but the cumulative effects made us vulnerable to everything, said Haitian entrepreneur Marc Alain Sicault on Twitter. It's going to take years to fix things and we have not even started. In Port-au-Prince, residents traumatized by the 2010 quake rushed, screaming, into the streets and stayed there as the aftershocks rumbled on. In my neighborhood, I heard people screaming. They were flying outside, said resident Sephora Pierre Louis. At least they know to go outside. In 2010, they didn't know what to do. People are still outside in the street. The quake sent shockwaves as far as Cuba and Jamaica, although there were no reports of material damage, deaths or injuries there. Everyone is really afraid. It's been years since such a big earthquake, said Daniel Ross, a resident in the eastern Cuban city of Guantanamo. I feel it, man. It wake me up. My roof kind of makes some noise, said Danny Bailey, 49, in Kingston. U.S. President Joe Biden said he had authorized an immediate U.S. response and named Samantha Power, administrator of the U.S. Agency for International Development, coordinator of the effort. Mexican President Andrés Manuel López Obrador also said he was ordering the government to prepare immediate relief to those affected of a big quake and give the right treatment or help they needed most of this time. This has been Leslie Kim Martin reporting.